Well, hey, it's 2022, and apparently I'm holding this ball. Cool. It's 2022. I don't know why I keep going like this. There's no fives in that. 2022. Ignore me. I'm done. I give up. Bye. Wow. Okay, so 2021 reading goals were an absolute mess, but I don't think I can be blamed for it. Okay, just hear me out, alright? Hear me out. I got kicked out in January, so I didn't actually have access to most of my books for about 10 and a half months of the year. Wait, hang on. No, it was the end of November. Yeah, okay, like, most of the year. So I literally couldn't get to most of these books to read them. I'll tell you what was on my list, and then I'll tell you which ones I actually read. So on my list, I did have, Loveless by Alice, you know, the one that wrote Heartstopper. I also had, Narnia, which... Yeah, it's technically like a bunch of books, but I have it in one copy, so for me, it's one book. The Girl on the Train, The Boy Who Steals Houses, Prey by Michael Crichton, you know, the Jurassic Park guy, 1984, This Is Where It Ends at 450 from Paddington, that's a Agatha Christie. The Book Thief, Pet Sematary was my Stephen King for the year. I had the collected works of Edgar Allan Poe on the list, and I had Dracula. So out of all of these, I believe I did attempt to read This Is Where It Ends right at the very start of the year, but I couldn't get into it, and then I got kicked out like a week later, so I never actually came back to it. But I did manage to read Loveless and The Boy Who Steals Houses. Now, I absolutely loved both of these. This was my first of Alice's novels that I have read. I've read the Heartstopper books, obviously, like, smashed them out. Read this as well and absolutely adored it. I was very excited to find a book about a character who was Ace Arrow and, like not a children's book, so that was really cool. So good. So I actually ended up buying and reading all of her other books as well, through the year. And The Boy Who Steals Houses, I absolutely loved this book. C.G. Drews did an incredible job. Honestly, I just want to wrap all these characters up and give them a big hug. Except, like, I don't hug people, and also not without consent. Come on, guys. So yeah, this one's about a character who feels weird because she hasn't been in a relationship before, but ends up figuring out that she's probably on the asexual and aromantic spectrums. Really cute, really wholesome, really funny, like, fun book, lovable characters, interesting, diverse, love it. And loved the rest of her books too, like, just gonna throw that out there. The Boy Who Steals Houses was about, there were these two brothers who, they're homeless, and they wait until people are, or they find houses that, where the owners are away, and they break into them and stay there the night. Sometimes they'll have some food and stuff, you know, look after themselves by breaking into other people's houses while they're away. Then they break into this one house and people come home and they end up, it gets all over the place. One of them is autistic as well. So that was really, really interesting to read a book with an autistic character. I have read one before, where, like, the main character is, like, explicitly stated to be autistic, and that was good, but it was very different. That was a child living with his parents, and it was an entirely different kind of situation. This, look, I really don't know how to describe this book. I just want you to know that I loved it. Okay, that's it, really. So I read a total of 25 books in 2021, somehow. Yeah. So that involved Heartstopper 3 and 4, of course. Involved a couple more Karen M. McManus books. I love her. Just gonna throw that out there. It was mostly Alice books. I read the big book of the Umbrella Academy Volume 1. I read a cute gay graphic novel called Bloom. I read a side novel to Death Note called the Los Angeles BB Murder Cases. That was... Bro, I have questions. Like, what were these people thinking when they wrote this, I guess? But, like, I mean, it's still... There were aspects of it that were good, and there were aspects of it that made me really want to just hit myself in the face with a brick. Repeatedly. Yeah. I read a couple more Scaldo-Ray Pleasant books. I'm still rereading them. I'm doing a terrible job at that. Yeah. I read The Chalk Man. A co-worker of mine is obsessed with this book. We work in a bookshop, and this is her go-to recommendation for everyone. I understand why. I do. I also remembered that there were graphic novels written about Avril Lavigne, so I got those and reread those as well. That was a trip. And the other book that I read this year, these are not in order, I'm just, like, spurting out nonsense, by the way. The other book I read this year was The Cellar by Natasha Preston. I do actually want to do a video individually on this particular book, because there is, honestly, quite a lot to discuss. Now, this book, I read Natasha Preston's stories back when she was on Wattpad, before she started publishing her books. I should not have been reading them at that age, like, first of all. I just absolutely not. I did remember quite a few things about this one in particular, but not as much as there is. And I reread this, and the whole time, all I could think of was, who let me read those at the age that I did? Bro, no wonder I'm so screwed in the head now. Honestly, like, what? I would have been, like, 13 when I first read this. That's not okay. It's really not. But also, I'm going to stop talking about this book because, as I said, I do want to do a video individually on that book. There's too much to talk about. There's too much to discuss. There's so much to unpack and just... So let's expect that at some point when I do get around to it. But then again, I've been saying this since I finished it months ago. I also said I was going to come back months ago. But yeah, I spent most of 2021 legally homeless, crashing in spare rooms. And that does make it a bit difficult to, first of all, access my books, but also to make videos and the time to edit and upload them. Where I was staying at the time of the last videos that I made when I said, hey, I'm coming back to YouTube, I had to leave that particular location a few weeks after that video got uploaded. And then I was somewhere else for a bit, and that was a mess. And now I'm here. I've spent the last month settling in here and getting used to that, and now it's 2022 and I'm coming back. I am doing it. I have so many plans. I'm not gonna just say I'm coming back and then not actually do it this time, I promise. Because I do have a place to myself. I have all the time in the world, all right? We are doing this, we're here for it, and this isn't just me saying shit and hoping it'll happen. I think. Anyway, if you've read any of these books or any of these authors, let me know. Let me know what you thought of them. Like, I genuinely so curious. And yeah, if you've got any other recommendations, feel free to drop them. Like, not that I need any. I have almost 700 books in this room. And I have read not very many of them. Anyway, thanks for watching. If there's any particular videos that you want me to do, or books that you want me to talk about, or go deeper into, I guess, yeah, let me know. And I will see you next time. Stay awesome.